What's up, Zombie Slayers? This is KJ48, and welcome back to my 7 Days to Die single player Let's Play. This is episode 11, and oh my god, I screwed up. Not royally, but I screwed up quite a bit. DX Story is really weird. Sometimes I hit the record key and it doesn't start recording. I have to start paying attention to make sure that DX Story is actually recording when I hit the record key. So I lost about 10 minutes of footage or something from this episode. Basically what I did was I looted up the rest of this house. There wasn't anything that great in it except for an ammunition book, which was pretty good. And then I went over here to the burnt biome and I found a campsite where I got the pot from, which is really nice. And I've decided I'm not going to walk through the campsite. I'm going to consider this kind of a dead end for now. I think the next way I'm going to explore is going to be over here somewhere. So I'm up in the attic of that house, and I'm going to break through this door. And I know it's dark for you, so let me see what I can do about that. There you go. How's that? A little better? All right. Yeah, I can't believe I did that. That's kind of a pain. You didn't really miss too much. You know, I just went through, killed some zombies, did a couple things. Nothing that major. But it's just I gotta make sure this thing's recording. When I hit the record button, I don't always look at the number, you know. Okay, got a few things we could take apart up here. Nothing there. Come on, give me something good. That is good. That is good. That's pretty much my favorite weapon in the game. Read that. And what we're gonna do is, we are going to look in. Hold on, let's break these up. I can't really tell. Oh, yeah, I want to know what I need to make shotgun shells with. So let's see. Shotgun shells. I already have the book for shotgun shells. That is a beautiful thing. So I need buckshot, gunpowder, and paper. I can get all of that. I don't need anything special. Well, hold on. I probably shouldn't speak too soon. I might need something special in the forge to get buckshot. So let's be careful with that. But other than that, Yeah, that's really nice. I would like to get a shotgun soon. That would be sweet. Let's go ahead and put this torch down. And then we're going to take this bad boy apart. See if we get anything good out of here. I think you just get pipes and iron from this thing. You know, it's really not that worth it, to be honest. You don't get enough. Like, okay, a few pipes, but I can make pipes. So, I don't know if all this time is really worth it. I don't know. Some pipes. I guess you could scrap those. You get 16 for 8 pipes. Yeah, I don't think that's really that worth it, to be honest. I probably won't hit those things anymore. That's more for like early game. Like if you need a short iron pipe to maybe make your first forge or something, then yeah, maybe then I can see it. But other than that, I don't know. I'd kind of rather just move on. Anything over here? I'm trying to hide the trash can from me. Alright, and it seems like we are just going to be sitting up here at night, and it doesn't look like there's anything we can do. We're pretty set up here. Let's look at what we're going to do tomorrow, though. I'm thinking, again, what I'm doing here, in case you guys haven't been watching every video, or, you know, I'm just going to keep repeating it. I'm doing a circumference around my base here to see what's in the area, because if I could find something, actually my base is going to be right here. If I can find something good in this area, I will build here. But if there's no looting opportunities here, by looting, I mean a town or a city. The difference between towns and cities, well, a town is just a bunch of blocks, kind of like this. This is technically a town, but there should be more buildings on these roads. I don't know why there isn't. That would be considered a town. So towns are usually really good, even though this one kind of sucks. And cities are awesome. They're the hub cities, but they're also highly protected with the undead and very hard to get through without getting killed. And I need stuff like that around this area for me to make it worthwhile living here. Otherwise, I got to move on, you know? Because if you can't go loot, you're screwed. You're not going to get guns, you're not going to get anything you need. I'm a little bit worried about the random gen. I kind of feel like it might be a little bit more spread out than it should be. I'm worried that they kind of messed with it after last season, because last season I had everything I needed right where I needed it, you know? Like, it was all right there. I had plenty of places to go last season. And now this season, I find this. Like, look at this. This is like a city with two buildings. And this is not an isolated case. I've had this happen. Star Snipe and I found a town like this. And I actually saw towns like this when I was streaming. So I'm getting worried that their towns are not spawning all the buildings around them they're supposed to. I really hope that this is not indicative of the way towns are going to be from now on. Because what kind of town would have, like, two buildings? Like, that's, you know... What is this? I don't remember what that is, but... Anyway, yeah, so that's what we're doing. We're just basically scouting out this area to see if it's worth living here. I'm now going to pause the video, and I will come back in the morning. Okay, guys, here we are. We've got about 20 minutes until daylight. We are going to jump down out of this house, and we're going to go this way. Don't worry about this drop-off chest over here. As a matter of fact, I'm probably going to hit it again and drop more stuff off in it, and we'll just grab it when we come back. I forgot to mention you a couple videos back. I actually went to both of these drop-off chests, and these are both empty. And this is the only one with stuff in it. So let's do this. How do we delete the waypoint? So what is that? That's chest. So chest, why don't we, God, I should have did this at night. Whatever, we'll do this during the night next time. All right, let's go. We got some work to do. Okay. Here we go. And let's head on over to that drop-off chest. We're going to drop off some stuff in there, and then we are going to start heading out. Okay. Just dropped off a bunch of stuff, and here we go. All right. We will avoid zombies because there's really no need to... Oh, is that a bear? Oh, by the way, they changed zombie bears, guys. Zombie bears will now never give up the fight. They will never stop chasing you, which I find kind of strange, because even regular zombies stop chasing you. So that's pretty interesting. I don't know how you're supposed to get like away from a bear if you can't kill him. Does that mean you're just dead? Or, like, I don't know. I don't know how that's going to work. It's very strange that they made it so something in the game will never stop chasing you. All right, so I did have to put my jacket on during the night because it was cold, but I think I'm going to take it off now because I am assuming it's going to make me hot soon. So let's avoid that if we can. And let's keep an eye out for zombie bears. Now, I don't know if all bears are zombie bears. I guess not. But I don't really know. For all I know, they're all zombie bears. So we got to keep an eye. Oh, here we go. We found something. We found a gas station. So far, that's the only thing we found. Oh, and a poppin' pills. All right. Not my favorite shop, but it's up there. It's up there. If I had one shop I'd like to find, it would be a Working Stiff Tools, followed by a Born and Noble, followed by a Poppin' Pills. So this is still a pretty decent find, though. It's good. All right, let's waste some zombies. By the way, your melee damage is based on is based on your stamina. So at least in some ways, so. If you have to fight a zombie and you don't have any stamina, just go ahead and use your bow. She's dead. Just put one in your eye. Groin shot! Groin shot! Oh. Easy there, Chief. You know, now that I'm thinking about it, let's look around. You always want to hit the ones on the ground because you get triple damage. This is what I was saying the other day. The fact that they fall on the ground is kind of irrelevant because when you're facing a lot of them, you can't really take advantage of the fact that they're on the ground. You know, for that triple damage. Well, sometimes you can, but not often. Now we gotta kill some of these guys. I want to start looting. There we go. Good, good, good. What we need is some water. Oh, by the way, sunglasses also have negative to insulation. Because, you know, they're protecting your, you know, eyes from the sun. So. All right, we don't want that. All right. I think we should probably clear out the rest of the zombies before looting, but I'm not... Well, whatever. Again, the weapon I'm using, the club, is really, really strong. But I'm going to not use it too often because I do want to get my archery up. Or I won't use it exclusively. Oh, shotgun shells. I already have that, though. don't I? It's letting me read them again? That's kind of weird, right? Usually if you already have the item, it, you know... Yeah, whatever. Cho-cha shot. I think I said that right that time. Cho-cha. I want to loot her. You always want to loot the nurse zombies. As a matter of fact, I'm going to kill them last. Man, this bow is doing some good damage. Alright, keep an eye out. Oh, hold on. Let me reload my mind. Running a little low on arrows, too. Oh, there goes his head. Looks like we're getting some more spawns here. Alright, I'm gonna start meleeing because we gotta save some arrows for the big guys. Let's make sure there's nobody behind us, it's really important. Also, we need to loot. Okay. A lot of guys here. Is it a roaming horde or something? This seems like a roaming horde. I want to be really careful with these guys. Man, the combat's good. I mean, the combat in this game just took a... It just jumped leaps and bounds. Leaps and bounds. I mean, my goodness. Although, I'm not happy with the loot. Look at your head, man. You're dead. Stop freaking out. The loot is leaving something to be desired. Well, at least we're getting scavenging. Alright, let's go ahead and eat some of this. And let's go ahead and drink. And I think we can now loot. I think we just cleared this area. It's good. I might actually stay here tonight. What time is it? I guess what time it is. Maybe. I don't know. I'll probably stay here tonight, but I won't like stay in the area the whole night. I'll probably just like look around. Freaking cars. Never got nothing for me. That's not true. I've gotten some okay loot out of cars. It's just there's a lot of them, you know, so you don't get that much loot because you gotta loot like 10 to get something when normally you would only have to loot one to get that same item, but there'd only be one car like every 10 miles or something. Basically what I'm saying is there's more cars, so they have to spread the loot out a little bit. Alright, let's take a look at what we got here. Scrap. We won't scrap that. Oh boy. I think we need to pick a home for the night and set up another drop chest. Got my cowboy hat back. Alright, yeah, I'm gonna set up a drop chest and get ready to loot the rest of the town. I don't like looting when I have full inventory, it's annoying. Pretty clean up here. Okay, we're back. Alright, so I just went ahead and made a chest and, you know, sorted all my stuff. I also changed some of my gear. I put on the cowboy hat and the jacket and the sunglasses. So, my insulation is 27. It's going up. I don't know if it's going to be a problem. I'm probably going to have to take off the jacket. So, we'll see how that goes. I also need to make some more arrows. They're going to have to be crappy arrows because I don't have any arrowheads. But that is okay. Now that you only get one arrow per combine, yeah, you're gonna need a lot of those iron arrowheads. So it's not gonna be so easy anymore to keep them all. Plus, I'm trying to get my archery skill up, so that's taking, you know, that's taking points as well. As a matter of fact, we don't have any stone, do we? No, we don't. All right, let's drop off some of the crap we just picked up and head on out. Do some more loom. It sounds like we got a zombie to kill. I definitely gotta save that bow. For, you know, bigger game, like not just the regular guys. I'm trying to use the bow on stuff I don't really need to, just because I want to like get the experience of getting better. Not only in-game experience, but that counts too. But also experience for myself, like learning to use the bow. Okay, I think that's about it down here in the back. Okay, let's go inside. We got that. That's search the toilets. Everyone keeps telling me to search the toilets. Eventually I'm gonna find something good in there and thank you, but as of right now, ain't doing nothing for me. Alright, we're gonna have to break through here. And let's see what we got. Oh, what's that? Oh, that's leather chest armor. That looks pretty cool. Look at it. It looks cool. I like it. You know what it looks like? It looks like a flak vest, like a bulletproof vest. All right. Well, let's put that bad boy on. And that goes right over my stuff. Unfortunately, my insulation is going up even more. But, you know, we'll see what we can do. I can make iron armor. Actually, when I get back to my base, I'm definitely going to make iron armor. Ooh, riddle of steel. So now I can make steel. So I can make the steel pickaxe now. Okay, that's it down here. I'm not getting the stuff I'm looking for, but I'm still getting good stuff. Which is always nice. Always nice. Alright, let's go out here. Go out in front. See what else we got in here. I think one thing I'm guilty of is when I go to an area, I don't loot everything. I kind of like just loot a little bit and then go off to the next area. I think I need to loot everything. You know, with 30-day respawns, I mean, in 30 days I can come back. So... where you going, chicken? You going nowhere. Seriously? Give me a sec. Okay, I'm back. Now, what the heck was I doing here? Oh, yeah, chicken. Oh, that's not good. Forgot. I totally forgot about the chicken. There you go. Get him. Get him. Give me those feathers. Give me that meat. I am finding a lot of food on the road. It's pretty interesting. Okay, scavenging 17. By the way, there was a bug before where scavenging at level 20 would bug out and you would get all your inventory you looted would be empty. So, I was saving up some points to just skip over a couple levels, so like, once I get to 20, I could just skip past that bug. But apparently they fixed it in last update, so. And don't get too excited with that, gasoline. Gasoline is not the way it used to be. 412 is like nothing. I think 412 might be equal to like, 4 cans of gas, the way it used to be, so. Yeah, so what's up with these towns? They're like a couple, 3 buildings, but... like, I need a town. Pretty disappointing, but... oh well. Let's see what it's got for us. At least we got a bunch of honey, that's good. Infection will not be a problem for us, which is always... it's always a problem. It's honestly, it's the first thing that you're gonna have a problem with in any game of 7 Days to Die. I'm gonna repair this axe. I don't want it to get destroyed. I know there's a few more hits on it, but I don't care. I just, you know. see how low it goes. 18. Okay. Oh, it didn't get repaired all the way. That's interesting. Has it not got repaired all the way before? I thought it got repaired all the way before. I don't know what's up with that. Okay, let's see what we got here. This is a good store. It's a good find. Okay, always check the cash registers. And always check the coolers. Cash registers for coins, coolers for beer. Alright, let's go ahead and drink. Buy a lot of food and water on the road. That's pretty cool. I'm very happy about that. Alright, now for the... This is when loot timers start to get to you a little bit. Really? Why are you all empty? Come on, man. You're killing me. How about a perk? Ooh, that's a good find right there. That's a damn good find. The beaker. Oh, my God. We are finally getting some stuff here. I really need a gun, though. We're going to need a gun already for the 14-day horde. The 14-day horde ain't going to be no joke. I'll probably start on my base pretty soon. I guess I'm just going to build in this area. I really don't know what else to do. Because I'm starting to think that it's not just this area that's got no towns. I'm starting to think the game doesn't have towns anymore. I haven't seen one since I've played. And I played on the stream. I've played a decent amount. And I've not seen any towns yet. All I've seen is like 1 to 3 building, you know, areas. Yeah, I haven't got anything good in those toilets yet. Is there anything I want to break up? I don't think so. We can throw this out, and break this up. Okay. Man, scavenging goes up quick, don't it? Oh, getting hot. And I just leveled up. What do I want to do with my points? I'm gonna save them and just keep putting them in Quality Joe. I don't know, why not? Might as well. Maybe toolsmithing? Toolsmithing, yeah, that's, yeah, maybe. I've got some ways we can get around the toolsmithing thing, though. Like, we can just make, like, stone shovels over and over and over to level up our toolsmithing. Might be a good idea. What am I looking at here? What the hell was I supposed to do? Oh, yeah, take off my jacket. There we go. Okay. You're gonna loot everything in this place, man. No joke. We will use those pills, though. These pills remove dysentery, but I really like the wellness that they give you. I don't think they give you one wellness, though, because I take one and my wellness doesn't go up. So. Okay, now I just took two and my wellness didn't go up. So they're either bugged or I'm, like, they don't work the way I think they do. And there's a lot of them in here. Hopefully I don't need that splint anytime soon. Damn it. Freaking. I'm just gonna eat this dog food. Just get the hell out of it. Let's get it out of here. Can't take it. Let's use this. Come on, wellness. Alright, so that's 3 vitamins that are supposed to be plus 1 wellness and didn't do anything for me. My wellness just went up. Maybe they're on a delayed effect. Like a wellness over time thing. Oh, I didn't want that. Whatever, just throw that out. Where was the stuff I did want? Did I loot it? It was in the garbage, wasn't it? Yeah, there we go. Okay. Oh, we need those. Okay, we gotta go drop stuff off and come back. Okay, heading back. Just gonna do a little bit of looting off camera, but I don't like doing looting off camera because if I find something really good, then people are like, oh, you just spawned it in. Like, so I like to make sure anything I find, you're there with me when I find it. Come to Papa. Anything else over here? You're empty. You're untouched. Empty, empty. Untouched. Untouched. Oh yeah, something in here I wanted. Potatoes. It's good. So we got everything. We got potatoes, corn, and coffee. That's one thing. We need to hit that. Yeah, we need to do some farming. I think we're going to live... Like I said, I think we're going to live in this area because I have a strange feeling that the game just has less prefabs or something's going on with the prefabs. I don't think I'm going to go somewhere else and find anything better. So we will live in this... We'll live in this area. And there, who knows? There might be some other stuff we can get. I mean, there's still a lot of unexplored stuff around, so... I'm just going to assume... We got to start building our base, though. That's the thing. Got to start building it. What am I doing here? Nothing, nothing, sorry. That's good. There we go. Scavenging skill is almost 20. Oh, God. You know, I was just looking at my hunger and thirst meter. And I gotta say, one thing I love about this game that other games do not do in the survival genre is you need to drink a lot more than you need to eat in this game, which is the way it is in real life, and it really bothers me. In like other games, you need to eat more, or maybe you do them evenly. No, you definitely need to drink more than you eat. So, I really appreciate that. Okay, one more. And when it rains, it pours with the beakers, huh? Okay. We don't need that. We don't need that. We don't need these. And that is it for this building. Complete on day 9. That means on day 39, we can come back here. I imagine on day 39, we won't need to come back here, but... We can if we want to. You know what this looks like? You know what this looks like? This looks like the underground bunker area. Now, I don't want to say anything before I go check it out, but this is the exact backyard that they have in the underground bunker. The underground bunker has always been in the desert. This is the underground bunker, guys. Wow. I found my home. Found my home. Now I have a question for you guys. I have a question. Let me know in the comments what you think. Is it cheating? Will it make you hate the Let's Play? Do you think it'll be lame? What do you think about staying in the underground bunker during day 14? What do you think? Let me know in the comments. I'm leaning against it, but man, it would be really cool. It seems like such a waste not to do it. But this is going to be my home. I'm going to stay in there. I'm going to live in the underground bunker any day that's not the 7-day horde. Got some zombies. Well, one. You got wrecked, sister. This is awesome. Oh, look at that. Small engine. That's not what I wanted. I wanted the damn, what do you call it? Ooh, that's nice. Do I have those already? I might. It's kind of weird that, like, even if you have them, you can still read them. I don't know what's up with that. I'm going to break into that tomorrow, though, because that's going to take a while. Right. Oh, I already have that. Oh, read it again, why not? Well, I could probably turn it into paper, but whatever. Let's make some room here. Scrap, scrap, use. Shut up. Yeah, this is the way you breathe through the other underground bunker. That's like a like a oxygen filtration system or something. Actually, you know what? I got a couple in-game hours. I'm gonna break the underground bunker. I won't break in though. I'm just gonna start breaking in, and we're gonna call this video here anyway. See how long this is gonna take. All right, that's gonna do it for episode 11. We'll see you next time for episode 12. Till then, take it easy.